Hello, this is a short video on downloading and installing Zotero. So to get to the Zotero website, I'm just going to do a search on Zotero. It usually comes up right away. There it is. So I'll click once on that. Front and center on the Zotero webpage is the download link. So I'll click once on download. Zotero works with different platforms, the default set for Windows, but there are other platforms available, and they're listed below the download button. So it works with Mac as well as Linux. So in this video, I will download Zotero 5.0 for Windows, the desktop program, and I will also show you how to install the connectors. So let me go and download, click the download button for the desktop, and you can see down here it's beginning to download. And while that's working, I will install the connector. The connector works with different browsers. The default is set for Chrome, but if you go a little bit further down the page, there's Zotero connectors for other browsers, and they're listed here. I will install the Chrome connector. So I click on that button. And then there's an Add to Chrome button right here. I'll click on that. And then click on Add Extension. And that should add the connector to my browser. And that appears, the connector appears at the top right hand side of the browser here. So this is the connector, and that's a key part of the Zotero program. So now let me go to the back to the download. It's downloaded. I'm going to get that started. So I clicked on it. And I am going to click run. That's extracting the files. It's usually pretty quick. And then you should see a box pop up. So this will walk you through the setting up Zotero. It's usually fairly easy. I'll just click next. I'll stick with the standard version. That's fine. So I'll click next. Lets me know where the Zotero will be installed. I'll click the install button. And it begins the installation. So after the installation ends, you'll get this screen, and I'll just click on the finish button, and Zotero will automatically start. This is what it looks like. And Zotero works well with Word, and Zotero should automatically be added to Word during the installation. Let me show you what that looks like. I am just going to open up a blank document. So you'll see at the top, a Zotero tab has been added to Word. And when I click on that Zotero tab, this is where I can add or edit citations within Word, as well as add and edit a bibliography. So that's what that add-in is. I'm going to close that and go back here. One thing you might want to do is get a free Zotero online account. The advantage of having an online account is that it helps you facilitates access to your citations anywhere you are with using different computers, as well it gives you the option to work with others, to share your citations with others. So to get a Zotero account on the Zotero homepage, let me go back to that. There's a login. Now I already have a login. I already have an account, so it's automatically entering my login information. But if you're new to Zotero, click on the register for a free account. And it's very simple. You just select a username, put in your email, and then select a password. Once you do that, then you can, let me go back to Zotero. If you do get an online account, you'll want to sync that account with your Zotero desktop program. Now do that in the Zotero desktop program. Go to the top left-hand corner, click on Edit, and then Preferences, then select Sync. This is where you can enter in your username and password. So I would enter in my username and password, if I can remember it, and then set up syncing. And now my Zotero desktop is syncing with my Zotero online account. I'll just click OK. And so that's it in getting started with Zotero. We have our desktop program, we have our connector, and we also have our online account. If you do have questions, feel free to contact us here in the library, and we'll be happy to try and help.